Good morning. First of all, I would like to say thank you to Linux Foundation and Open Source Summit to give me this opportunity to share with you Alibaba's exploration into digital-driven open source community. My name is Frank Zhao. I am a community manager from Alibaba. I used to be a frontier developer, and I have been very interested in open source. And last year, I joined Alibaba to be a technical engineer on open source. And first of all, let's look at the orgs here. On GitHub, we have 20 plus orgs, more than 1,000 repos, and around 11,000 contributors now. And on the right, you could see these in-depth foundations we've participated in. And for CNCF, we have also deeply engaged into it. And Li Shang, on CNCF, is a TOC member. And our Dragonfly has also been the very first sandbox project on CNCF. And we also have some ASF projects, Rocket MQ, Double, and Wix, which is still in incubation. And Fengjia, ASF IPMC member, and Zhang Huxing, also ASF member responsible for Double, and also one of the very few ASF individual members. And then let's look at the content here. I'm going to talk about. First, I would like to say our requests as companies for open source, and then some analysis based on GitHub from a digital-driven perspective, and then our open source management and operation work. And then let's look at the request for open source from different perspectives. We have, first of all, request on data analysis. It is from a perspective of a strategic team. As a strategic team, we do not care about failure or success of certain one or few projects. We care about what developers want to do and how they would like to do. And on GitHub, we have so many source codes of Git. Of these GitHubs, but there are also some behavior data on these developers. And we need to have some basic definitions, for example, about the activity of the project and developers, and then we would like to categorize the open source projects. And the categories can tell us among tens of thousands of projects, which category they belong to, and where the developers are distributed and what they're doing. And the third analysis we need to do is to predict the tech trend based on the open source developers' behaviors. The changes in their behaviors can indicate the changes in the overall industry development trend. And then about the open source project management, which is similar to the governance of the open source projects. One big challenge is that we have a huge number of projects here at Alibaba. We have more than 1,000 projects. And for governance of these projects, most important would be about project legal and security compliance. But the approach to compliance would be very challenging. And for the third-party companies, how to manage with the continuous compliance will be another big challenge for us. And then about the project operation, for single projects, the operation would be about the conversion of the developers, like to engage more interesting developers into our projects to become the contributors, to the committers, the container and also the maintainer and the evangelists, that would be very important. And we want to encourage these developers to become more active. And also, we want to execute the community mechanisms. As previous speakers mentioned, that we have the code of conduct for the developers' behaviors, but how to execute them and implement them would be important as well. And before we move on, we would like to define the activity of the projects and developers. We need to have a quantifiable measure standard. We do not see it based on star, we just analyze their behavior data. GitHub gave us some developer behavior relevant data, and we can further develop some formulas and try to predict that. And first is about the developer activity. We would see their review comments and comment numbers, open issue numbers, open and merged PR numbers to see how their activity would be. And as a big internet company, we want our projects to engage more people to do the code review to enhance its robustness. And then about the project activity, we would have a weighing of weighting of the developer activity altogether to have the project activity. And it will also balance the core developers' activities influence on the project activity. So with this equation, we can see more advantages from those communities with more developers engaged. And then we will look at the project relativity. We would see all the developers and their correlation with the project and try to calculate the relativity. And for example, a developer, when he's active for both projects, then he's influential on both projects. And this is how we would like to analyze, and also maybe these methods are not quite applicable in all cases. However, in our cases, it would be very useful. And then let's look at the analysis result based on GitHub. First of all, about our analysis background, it is about the event log on GitHub. And it is open for download. And the event log is in large volume, so we just extract the data from the year 2018. And it involves all projects on GitHub. And there are altogether 2.98 million projects all over the year on GitHub, and let's see the most active ones. And the result turned out to be unexpected, but not that surprising. And we can see the most active projects were about automation projects and robots. And we can see Greenkeeper, DependBot, and Renovate, these projects for automated updates. And Hunt CI is about code review. And here we could see Kubernetes CI robot. It is especially for Kubernetes, and it could rank 11, number 11 globally. We can see how active it is. And as strategic team, we always consider about what the developers would consider, would need. And here, the results gave us some hints. For example, for large-scale automation, maybe they are the rigid need for the open-source developers, for dependency and CI, and automated updating and writing, education, etc. These are about their rigid needs. And then analysis on most active projects. We can see before we had this project, we would look at Octopus, which was the official report by GitHub every year, to show us the top 10 popular projects. However, we rank all 2.98 million projects, and we can see the top 20 would cover all top 10 projects from Octopus. And we can see Microsoft, Facebook, Google, unsurprisingly, were all covered by the top 20. And then it could tell us which communities were doing it quite well, and we would like to investigate into the reasons why they had this good performance. And then, more interestingly, we would analyze the project's relativity. We can see the ecology here.
It is
with the core of Kubernetes and the most relative projects to it. If you pay attention to the official Weibo of CNCF, they already posted this graph to show their diversity in their ecosystem about a top-level open source projects and what they can do. And we can see the most relative projects here would include the community, example, websites, projects. These are very active and their contributors would be up to hundreds. And in China, very few projects could own these many contributors. And we could see on the outer cycle, the Go line is very strongly relative to it as well, about the development language, and the two pink ones, Helm and Chomp.
Actually,
there are already some commercial companies based on Kubernetes to gain profits. It all shows us what a successful open source company could do. And then about a category of these projects, we can see we've selected 8,000 projects with stars more than 5,000. And here we have draw this conclusion, which is not very good because there are some factors influencing it. Very interestingly, for Facebook projects, they have a very strong integration here and they could actually form a category here. So actually, in terms of categorization, we didn't achieve a very good result, and for the prediction, we didn't do much yet. However, I think for people who major in AI and big data, this is a very good project for them to practice, and some universities have started to work with us to let their labs and students help us do the analysis work, which is a very good practice for their students, and I believe they can harvest very good results. And then let's look at the digital-driven open source management. Well, here it contains not much because it is more about the construction of our inner platforms. We have some continuous platforms for continuous data collection and continuous project monitoring. And in terms of legal compliance and security compliance, we would have more concentrated work, but these are more about internal work. And then let's look at the project operation. First of all, let's look at how we detect the active developers in the community. As far as I know, for Apache or even Apache Foundation, when we propose committer, it is more about our subjective opinions. We do not have any data to judge it. There was no like strict process to go through, like voting to see who will be upgraded to a committer. But here, let's see how we conduct this. This is our new open source project, CETA, and this could be a good example. This is about the activity from January to May of CETA developers, and we could see some of them have been highly active. These are our own employees.
So they were up in the community, and they have embedded into the community, and they have become the core members. Also, we have lots of other developers. They come and go.
Some are
increasing and some decreasing. Some work for only 2 to 3 months. So as the managers, we need to quickly locate these contributors with the contribution within a short period of time. Otherwise, they would not be retained.
The next question,
how to stimulate this contributors. For the very good projects, we have made lots of research, and we found that if we can help our contributors to become, to involve in the management, administration of products, this would be helpful to improve their belonging to the community. And for a longer time period, they would be more engaged and included into this community. Let's take Kubernetes as example. If you know this, you would understand that it has a very robust
help
for the project management work. Also, they have the general management for the projects, and nobody has the direct authorization for PR approval, and everything will be managed by robotics. How can robotics know? They will have comments and send comments that say, I think this can be approved. So if they will receive 2 approval, then they will directly approve it. So the authorization is based on approval, and they can engage in this way. By doing so, they can evolve in this management better instead of making pure contributions. And also, we have about 990 owners' files to describe the reviewers, the approvers, and how to distinguish. So you can see here, altogether, we have 523 developers involved in this process, which means about 70% developers involved in project management work. If we have a look at Kubernetes single project, we have 422 owners' files, and 14% of them involved into project management. And I believe that if this kind of community is not active, then this doesn't make sense. The third aspect for the specs, how to force it for execution. Lots of problems. We mentioned this several times, that the code of conduct does not need to show or include the specific types of languages or behavior. But as far as I know, they don't have the capability to set the blacklist, because this is open, so you cannot repel anyone from this. So also the PR cooperation process, if we receive or if we order cross review, then anyone authorized will have the right to approve and or to review. So no problem for this. Let's also take Kubernetes and robotics, for example. In Kubernetes community, this is forced to execute because nobody has the right to review. And they need to get the orders, the commands from robotics. to execute. So I think that automation robotics will play a very critical role for the inclusion of this community and also our aspirations for automation. We have a CleverBot project, open source, in-depthly integrated with Gitbox. GitHub, mainly for the capture and analysis of data. And our ultimate goal is to drive the force execution for the code of conduct in this community and to become the core tool for the management. But this is our ultimate mission. Currently, this cannot reach this goal. So these are what we can do now. As you can see on the left, let's take Narcos project. It produces a weekly report about the data in this week and to upload this, to submit this data to help you understand the changes within this week and who are the active members. And also mention the new contributors to thank them. On the right, the automated marking performance by matching the keywords. And down below, you could notice the automatic translation function, because Alibaba has very high requirements for globalization, so we do hope that developers across the world can get on board. But in the beginning phase, only Chinese developers will submit issues in this platform, but the overseas developers will not understand. For dealing with this, with the Chinese language, the robotics will automatically translate. We don't modify this, and we will submit this by means of comment. And this also mentions that this is automatically translated. So if you raise your questions, then this would be more friendly to the other developers. We want to make it a tool to help different developers to communicate better and to understand each other. But we didn't expect that this played a very important education tool role. And after several periods of operation, lots of operators and developers, they submit questions in bilingual language, not only Chinese. And this is unexpected. And eventually, we aim to make it a complete community management tool, but it takes a long time. And also in this process of development, with OxyKit, we have a very frequent communication. For API SDK management and also the ProBox system, they have engaged in our project in-depthly, and also we help them to develop the GitHub dedicated testing framework. The event-driven API-based testing has lots of pain points. It's very hard to make it on the data hub and very hard for testing. Now they are testing framework, and we are also will be one of the earliest users. So this is my introduction today, my presentation and questions. Thank you. I have a question. Alibaba's open source in China has done very well. Your performance is really good. So open source can help us to standardize the code. Any other benefits in addition to this for Alibaba? Lots of keynote speakers have shared with us the benefits of open source. A lot to mention. For example, I've shared with you a lot, and Facebook speaker also mentioned a lot the presence of your brand, branding, and the recruitment, and customer retention, etc. So a lot. And we can communicate this respect offline. So lots of speakers have mentioned this, and I prefer to share with you about this offline. Thank you. Alibaba, as you mentioned, will give lots of incentives to the excellent developers of the community. In addition, for the authorization review and approval, any other methods you will grant them. For the active developers, when they submit their CVs, any advantages they will enjoy? Of course, lots of open source projects and the maintainers are recruited from community. And these, if they involve in our projects for a long time, we do want to welcome them to join us. And also, we have lots of tokens and souvenirs and credentials, certificates. All this will be provided.
Thank you for your talk. Very thank you for your sharing. My
You cut those top 20 for your choice? 那这个是完整的一个名单，还是说是一部分的名单？
Sorry, 能不能讨论一下这些指标？ 这样的话我们可以实现整体的一个标准化。 我可能会私下跟你沟通，谢谢。
Thank you. My question is in the roadmap management of this project. Anything to share with us?
Thank you.
Lots of traditional communities have published essays, including Mozilla, etc., and they have really excellent experience to share us, to share with us that we what we need to focus on is not the specifics, the details,
and insight,
or our vision in the long term. Are more compelling, but we also have very clear feature management and project management. The project manager needs to be responsible, and for today, I mainly focus on data management.
You Log,
captured data hub logs for analysis. Also, you have targeted categorization 0.1, 0.2, and 0.5. So I think if you have enough data for open source projects, you would have some awareness and recognition, and you would label it. So you could take some models to build the weighing factor. And this would be very universal. Also, looking to the future, when it comes to management tools, I personally feel that in terms of whether this is reasonable, you need to focus on it more. Because now seems that your focus is more on Alibaba's projects and your own experience and your insights on the basis of this previous insights. But how to make it more reasonable and universal? You need more input from data and more insights from data. So I think that targeting the future, any plan you will make to make it better and to promote this into the real development or developers community.
Within this year,
we have done lots of exploration-based work, not a kind of a solid foundation of theory to support this. But I think what we are doing now marks a very good beginning for the colleges and universities. So we would collaborate with these universities and to attract more students to join us for the open source analysis. And also, as you mentioned, the community development tools. I think we need to set a very scientific model. But now in China, nobody works for this. And I also feel very confused whether I have think a lot. I've thought a lot. A good point to share with you. Yesterday, I communicated with Brian, the architect of Red Hat, and Brian mentioned I told him, I asked him, whether it's possible to set the universal architecture. Within this architecture, the developers would enjoy convenience and quick speed to shift and reduce the cost for the operation mechanism. So the barrier of entry would be lowered. And Brian answered me, now in the overseas countries, the professors leading their students working for this, actually lots of difficulties. And technology or development alone cannot solve these pain points. The first speaker today shared with us about how to build the open source community from the perspective of development and research, and also how to make it better. And in some books, we learned that in the future, the corporate management and community management will be converged. So in the future, maybe we will cooperate more with universities, colleges, and to lay the solid foundation for theory on this basis to build the tops. I have a follow-up question. The holistic management system within Alibaba, have you deployed this in the cross-department collaboration? For example, you use some methods of data analysis to stimulate the other department. So for review or audit, for big companies, the internal open source contribution would be more urgent than the external. Now we focus more on GitHub, external oriented. I've shared with you lots of projects, CETA, Sentinel, started this year. So this connected with the system from day one and very helpful for CETA community development, and they will quickly discover the active developers and gave them tasks and stimulate them to develop faster. So this has been verified by practice, but I'd like to say that we don't have a solid theory foundation. Thank you. This is my sharing with you today.